Hello everyone, welcome to Geeks for Geeks. I am Chaitanya Munjay and in this video we will be creating a chatbot application in Android. So this chatbot application will answer some common questions to the users. For building this application we will be using BrainShop API which will send the response to the user's queries. So I have already built a sample application for the demo. Here we will take a look at what we are going to build in this video. So here is the simple application in which we are going to display edit text and a floating action button. Inside edit text we are entering the message for our chatbot, so we will simply type hi and then we will click on send button to send message to our chatbot. After that our chatbot will instantly reply with some response. After that we will send another query that tell me a joke and we will simply click on send option. After that we will get to see the response from our chatbot. So this is how we are going to create in this application. Now let's move towards creating a new application in Android Studio. Here first of all we will create a new project. We will select empty activity, click on next, name our application as chatbot. After that we are using Java as a programming language, so select Java and then click on finish to proceed further. Now our project has been successfully created. Here we can get to see our main activity.java file and activity_main.xml file. Now inside the demo application we will get to see this type of a UI. So for connecting to our chatbot we are connecting our application through internet. So first of all we will add the permissions for internet. In our manifest file, so click on the manifest folder. After that we have to add users and permissions and then we have to specify the internet permissions. Inside our application we are getting to see that these messages are coming in the from the API. So for fetching the data from the API we will be using Retrofit, which is a library to fetch the data from the JSON file. You can check out more about Retrofit on a Geeks for Geeks website, that is JSON parsing in Android using Retrofit library. So we are following this library for fetching the data from our JSON file. Now we will move towards Gradle scripts for adding the dependencies. Inside our dependencies section, so the first dependency will be for Retrofit and second will be for JSON converter. After adding this dependency, we simply have to click on Sync Now option to install all these dependencies inside our application. Now for fetching the data from the JSON file, we have to first of all generate a URL which will send the response to the user's queries. So for that, we will be using the BrainShop API which will send the response to the user queries. So for creating our API, we will first of all go to the brainshop.ai, this site. And then we simply have to create a new account. I have already created a new account. By going in this option, we can create a new account. I have already created, so we will simply go on login. Then I will log in with my credentials. Inside this, we simply have to click on Add Brain option. And we have to click on Create a Root Brain. Inside this, we have to specify the name for our application, that is chatbot, and we have to select the application as mobile app. After that, we have to rename it as a free, then click on save. After that, we simply have to click on the settings tab. Here is the API key, which will send us the response to our user's question. So we simply have to copy this one and we will test this API in our Postman. As we are making the GET request, so we will make it as a GET. Inside this URL section, we will add the URL. After that, in place of MSG, we will simply specify the message. And we will simply click on send. After that, this API will return the response that is in the JSON object form. So we will be using this response to display in the bot's response, that inside our application we will get to see this is the response which we have to display in the bot. So this one is the user's response, that is user's question, and this one is the response from the bot. So we will be displaying this response in our bot's in our recycler view. So now we will move towards our application. Now we have created our API key, we will be using this URL inside our application. Now inside Android Studio, first of all, inside our activity underscore main.xml, we will remove this text view, change the root layout to relative layout. Before proceeding further, first of all, we will update the colors file. So we have to go to the res, then values, and then colors. Inside this, we have to update the colors. So first of all, we will change the first color. After that, we will create other colors, that is, first one will be our background color. The next color will be for the bot background color, which then the next color will be for user background color, which will be light blue. And the last one color will be for our floating action button. Now we will move towards our activity underscore main.xml. Inside this, first of all, we will create a recycler view for displaying our messages. We will specify width as a match parent, height also as match parent. We will specify ID as IDRV chats. After that, we will again create a relative layout. We will specify width as match parent, height as wrap content, and we will align this at the parent bottom. We will specify ID to this relative layout as, and we will align this recycler view above to our, that is, relative layout of message. Inside this, we will create an edit text for set. Entering the user message, we will specify width as match parent, height wrap content. We will specify hint as enter message. Then we will change the hint text color to white. Specify ID text color to white. Here we will change the background color as back color. Inside this, we will add single line to true because we do not want to allow user to enter into the next line. So we will be adding as a single line to true. Now after that, we will be creating a floating action button, which will be used to sending the message. Specify width and height as wrap content. After that, we will align it to end. Align parent end to true. We will specify the source as image file. So we will be adding the image to it in our drawable folder. After that, we will specify ID. Margin as 4 dp. We will add fab custom size as 45 dp. This one will be for the color for our icon. Now we will add the icons in our drawable folder. So for adding the new icons, we have to go to the drawable folder, right click on it, then new, and inside this we have to click on vector assets. Now we have to search for send icon. Select this one. We will change the name as IC send, click on next and finish. After that, we will add the source as IC send. Now our send icon has been added. Along with that, we will align our edit text to left of our floating action button. And we will specify margin as 3 dp, layout centering parent as true. Now we have completed working in the activity underscore main.xml. Now as we are fetching the data from the API using the retrofit, so first of all we have to create a model class for fetching the data so that we can store this data inside our model class. So as we seen in the response, we are only getting the only one value, that is name as a cnt. So for this we have to create a model class to store this response. So for creating a new model class, we simply have to right click on our package name, new and java class, and we have to name our class as msg model and create our class. After that we have to create a variable which will be our string variable, and the name for the variable will be the same as this one, that is cnt. After that we simply have to create a constructor getter and setter method. So we will simply right click, generate, then click on constructor to create the constructor. Similarly, we have to create our getter and setter methods. This message model class will hold the data which we are getting from the API. Now for fetching the data, we have to create a interface class for the retrofit. So for creating this class, we simply have to go to our package name, right click on it, then new, select Java class. Here we have to change it to interface and name it as retrofit API. Now inside this, we have to make a request. That is, as we are inside the Postman, we have seen that we are making a get request for getting the data from the API. So we will also add the annotation here as get that is for getting the data from the API. After that, we simply have to make a call, and where we have to store the data. So we have to store it in our message model class, that is MSG model, and we have to name our method as get message, and inside this we have to pass the URL. So this will be the string, that is URL, which we have to pass. Now we will call this get message method for getting the message from our API, and inside this string we will pass the URL from which we are getting the API. Now we have created message model class Retrofit API. Now we will create another model class which will be hold the data which we have to display inside our recycler view. So we have to go to package name, right click on it, new Java class, and name it as a chats model. And we simply have to click on class. After that, we will create two variables, that is message and a sender. So the message will be for the message, and sender will tell us about which type of sender is it, whether it is a user or a bot. So for this, we are using the multiple view type recycler view. This means that when the user has entered the message, it will be displayed in the different view, and when we get the response from the bot, it will be displayed in the different type of view. You can check out more about this in our Geeks for Geeks article, which is mentioned in the description, that is multiple recycler view in Android. So in this, we are going to display the two different views. Inside our application, we will get to see that there are two different views. One view will be for our user and one view will be for our bot. So these are the two different views which we are going to show. So to identify that views, we are using the message. Message will display the data, and sender will tell us about who is the sender, whether it is a bot or it is a user. After that, we have to simply click on right click, then generate, and we have to create constructor for these two variables. After creating constructor, we have to create getter and setter methods for these two variables as well. Now we have created getter and setter methods along with our constructor. Now for handling data inside our recycler view, we have to create adapter class. Along with that, we have to create these two layout files that are being displayed here. The first layout file will be for our user message, and the second one will be for our bot's message. So first of all, we will add the icons that we are going to require in our project. So for getting the icons, we simply have to go inside our browser, type flaticon.com, and here we have to search our icons. That is, first one will be for user. Inside this, we simply have to click on this icon. Click on SVG to download this icon. Now this icon has been downloaded. Similarly, we have to download one more icon, which will be for our bot. We will simply type here chatbot and search for it. Now we will take this icon. We simply have to click on this icon, then SVG to download this icon. After downloading these icons, we have to go inside our Android Studio to import this in our project. So we simply have to go inside our Android Studio, and for adding this icon, we have to go to the drawable folder, right click on it, new, and then vector asset, and here we have to select local file. And from this folder, we have to navigate in which folder we have placed all the icons. Now in downloads folder, they are already present, so we will navigate them. So we will name that as user. We will change the size as 24 dB and then click on next to add this icon to our project. Similarly, we will add the icon for our bot. Go to the drawable folder, right click on it, new vector asset, local file. We will change simply the size as 24 dB. Click on next and then finish. Now we have imported all the icons which we have required, that is for send button, our chatbot and our user icon. So these are our icons which we have imported. Now we have to create the two XML files, that is layout file, one will be for user and one will be for bot. So we will move towards creating our XML file. We simply have to go to the layout folder, right click on it, new, and then layout resource file, and we simply have to name it as user message rb item. Change the root layout from constraint to card view, and we simply have to click on OK to create this file. Inside this we have to change width as wrap content, height also as wrap content, then specify gravity as end, margin as 5 dp, change card background color as user back color. Then specify elevation as 8 dp. After that, card corner radius also as 8 dp. Now inside this card view, we have to create a linear layout. Specify width as wrap content, height also as wrap content, orientation as horizontal. Now inside this linear layout, here we can get to see in our linear layout there are two views, that is first one is text view and next one is a image view. So first of all we will create a text view. We will specify width as match parent and height as wrap content. We will specify it as a user message text, then we will specify ID. We will change text color as white. Margin as 5 dp. Padding as 3 dp. Now we have created text view. After that we have to simply create an image view for displaying the image for our user. Specify width as 30 dp, height as 30 dp, source as user, margin as 10 dp. Now we have created inside our text view, we will simply change the, that is align it to the gravity as center. Change the gravity, that is layout gravity and then center, so it will align it to the center. Now we have created the UI for our user message, that one will be this one. Now we will create another layout file which will be for our bot response, we simply have to go to the layout, new layout resource file. Here we also have to change the root layout to card view. Click on OK to create this file. Here also we have to change width to wrap content, height also to wrap content. Here we have to specify gravity as start, margin as 5 dp, elevation as 8 dp, card background color as bot background color. We have to specify radius as 8 dp. Now inside this we have to create linear layout, specify width and height as wrap content, then orientation as horizontal. Now after that we will create an image view here. First of all, this will be for displaying the bot image, that is 30 dp, height and width as 30 dp, source as our bot image. Adding margin as 10 dp. After that we will create a text view, specify width as match parent and height as wrap content, specify id as idtv bot, text as bot message. We'll change gravity as center, text color as white, padding as 3 dp, margin as 5 dp. Now we have created a layout for our bot message along with our user message. After that we have to create our adapter class, which will set the data to each of our view, that is this one view along with the bot RV item. So for that we have to simply go to our package name, right click on it, new, then Java class, and name it as chat RV adapter. We simply have to click on create a new class. Inside this class we will extend it with the recycler view adapter. Inside this one we are using the multiple view type recycler view, so you can check out this article, that is to get more info that we are how we can use multiple view types of recycler view, that is for different views. After initial extending it with the recycler view adapter, we simply have to click on this red bulb to implement all our methods. After this we have to create, don't have to require this annotation, so we will remove this. After that we have to create our view holder class. This view holder class will holds the variables, that is we will create variables such as all the text views and the views which we are use inside this layout file, the first text view for setting the data. So we will create a view holder class. The first view holder class will be the for our user message, that is user view holder. Inside this we will extend this user view holder class with recycler view dot view holder. Now inside this class we have to click on, then click create our constructor. Now inside this we will create a variable for our text view, which is used to set data to our user message TV, that is user TV, and we will initialize with its ID inside our that is constructor, that is user TV item view. After that we will again create another view holder class, which will be for our bot passage, that is bot view holder. Extends recycler view holder. We will also create a constructor here. After that, we will create a variable for our text view, that is bot message TV. Item view dot find view by ID. That is ID TV bot. After creating this, we have to create two variables, that is one will be for array list and one will be for context. So we will create a variable for our array list in which we will be storing our data, array list, and the data type will be for our message model, that is chats model, and chats model array list. Along with that, we will create a variable for our context. Now we will create constructor for these two variables. So we have to simply right click, then click on generate and create, click on constructor, select all the variables and okay to create our constructor class. Now after that, inside our onCreate view holder, we have to create our view holder. So first of all, we will remove this one and we will create a variable for our view. Inside this, we will switch our view type, that is which view type is we have to show. Inside this, we will use switch case and we'll specify it as a zero. So for first condition, we have to inflate, that is layout inflator. And here we have to inflate our user message RV item. After that, we have to simply call return user view holder, and here we have to pass the view. And for case 1, we will change our view type, that is this will be our for bot parent dot get context inflate, and here we will pass our layout file as bot message rv item. And after that, we will simply call return bot view holder, and here we will pass our view. And at last, we will return null. And inside our onBind view holder, we will be setting our data, and inside get item count, we will simply return the size of our array list, that is chats model array list dot size. Inside our onBind view holder, we will first of all check who is the sender. So first of all, we will create a chats model and we will get the data from our array list, that is chats model array list dot get, and here we will pass our position. From this chats model, we will check who is the sender. So for that, we will simply add the switch case chats model dot get sender. And here we will check whether the sender is a user or a bot. For user case, we will call user view holder. Inside this, we will pass our holder user TV dot set text, and here we will set our text as chats model dot get message. In the case of bot, We will call our bot view holder dot bot TV, set text, chats model, and here we will call get message. Now we have completed coding in our adapter class. Now we will call this adapter class in our main activity.java file. Inside this, first of all, we will initialize all our variables which we have created in the activity underscore main.xml, that is the recycler view, our edit text, and a floating action button. So we will create variables for this one. Then we will create a variable for our edit text. Then for floating action button. Now we will initialize all our variables. After that, we will create two string variables, which will be for the first string will be for the user key and the bot key. So private final. And these keys will be similar to what we have mentioned in our adapter class. So here we are checking it with the string, that is whether it is a user or not. So we have to check that these keys will be the similar, that is user key and a bot key. So first one we have created is for bot, and the second one we will be creating it for user, and we will be specifying the same key, that is user. After that we will create a variable for our array list. Then for our adapter class. After that, we will initialize our array list, that is chat model array list. Along with that, we will initialize our adapter. Now we will set this adapter to our recycler view. First of all, we will add linear layout manager. We are specifying as vertical orientation, so we will simply specify as this. It will add vertical orientation to our recycler view. Then we will set this layout manager to our recycler view, that is set layout manager. Now we will set adapter as chats RV adapter. After that, we will add onClick listener to our send message web, that is floating action button. Inside this, first of all, we will check whether the message entered by the user is empty or not. If it is empty, we will simply display a toast message. Please enter your message. And we will simply call on the return. After that, if the user message entered by user is not empty, so we will call a method. Inside this method, we will be getting the data from our API. So for that, first of all, we will create a method. GetResponse. And inside this, we will passing our message, which is written by the user. So we will call this method here, that is get response, and inside this we will be passing the user message edit get the data from user message edit dot toString. And after that we will simply set the data in user message edit text as empty. Now inside the get response method, first of all we will be adding the user message. Add. So first of all we will be adding our user message, that is this one will be the user message, and along with that we will be adding the key, that is user key. So here we have created the user key, so we will be adding as a user key. After adding this data we will simply notify our adapter that the data inside our array list has been changed. So we will simply call our adapter and call notify dataset change method to notify our adapter the data has been changed. After that we will create a variable, that is URL, in which we will be passing our URL. So we have inside our Postman we have already taken our URL, so we will simply copy this URL and will paste here. Now inside our URL we will simply remove the hello message which is constant, and we will add our message which we will get from the user input. Along with that we will have to create another variable for base URL of our, and inside this we have to pass the base URL. The base URL this one, this will be our base URL. Now after that we will call our retrofit interface class, that is first of all we will call retrofit retrofit.builder. And inside this we will pass our base URL as base URL, and inside this we will add conversion factory as JSON conversion. As we are passing the data in from the JSON format, so we are using JSON conversion factory dot create, and we will simply call build method to build it. After that we will call our interface class which we have created, that is retrofit API, create a variable for it. And we will call our method, that is create, and inside this we will pass our retrofit API dot class. After that we will make a call MSG model, and we will create a variable inside this we will make a call, that is our retrofit API dot get message, and inside this we will pass our URL. After that we will make a call, that is to enqueue and to get the data from our API. Inside this we will add a callback, and these methods are already been created, that is we have to create a new callback, and inside this we have to specify our model class, that is MSG model. Now the two methods has been created, that is on response and on failure. So inside the on response we have to check whether the response is successful or not. We will call response dot is successful, and inside this we will get the pass the response inside our message model class. So we will create a message model and pass response dot body to pass the response to our message model class. After that we have to get this from the our message model class and pass it to our array list, that is chats model array list dot add new chats model, and inside this first will be our message. So we will get our message from our chat dot get cnt, and along with that we will pass our bot key. After that we will notify our adapter that the data has been updated inside our array list, so we will simply call notify dataset change. And in on failure method we will add the data to our array list as can you please revert a statement. So we will add, that is chats model array list dot add new chats model, please revert your question. And we will specify our key as a bot key. And chat RV adapter dot notify data script here. Now the coding part has been completed. Now we have to run our application to see the output of our application. Now we have run our application. Now we will take a look towards the output of our application. Here we will first of all enter the message. And we will simply click on send. Now our app has been crashed. We will check for the errors in the logcat. Inside our chat RV adapter, we forgot to add the method as get item view type. So this method will simply help us to return the specific integer that here we are using the case 0 and 1. So we have to inform our onCreate view holder that which layout to inflate. So inside our get item view type, we will simply create a switch case, and here we'll call chat array list, and inside that we will pass our position and we will get our sender. After that we will add the key, that is case user, and in case of user we will simply return as 0. Here in the onCreate view holder we can see that in 0 case we are displaying our user message RV item. Now we will create another case which will be for our bot, that is bot, and we will simply return 1 for default. We will simply return -1. Now we will run our application again and check for the output. Here we will first of all add the message, that is hello, and we will simply click on send. Now here we can get to see we are getting the response from our chatbot. I hope you get to know what we have built in this video. If you have any doubts, suggestions, then comment down below your thoughts. Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe Geeks for Geeks YouTube channel for more updates.